The government of Zimbabwe set aside the year 2030 as a target for the attainment of an upper middle income economy for the country. Among other services that add to the attainment of an upper middle income goal is the provision of clean and potable water for everyone, provision of world-class health for all, world-class housing for all, education for all, and provision of reliable sources of energy, among other variables. This has seen the innovation of rural-based industries such as the Mwenezi Mapfura Amarula plant, Mutoko fruit and vegetable processing plant, the Mount Meru oil processing plant in Seke, among others. In addition to this, the government has launched the Marondera University of Agricultural Sciences and Technology Agro-Industrial Park in Marondera District. The project was financed by the government to the tune of $262 million through the Minister of Higher and Tertiary Education, Innovation, Science and Technology Development on the basis of Education 5.0.
Education 5.0 speaks about ensuring that we don't only teach, we don't only do research, but we also innovate, come up with new things and new ideas, and that we also produce industry in the process. So, kana tichitaura about Education 5.0, we are speaking about an education that will produce goods and services. And for that to happen, it means that we must produce students who not only are able to remember important things, but who are also able to do. As you can see what we have here at this project, this is a place where our students are going to be able to come to learn, to do, and to demonstrate to the rest of the world what they are capable of producing. This is also a place where they are going to learn about value addition. This is a place where they are going to learn about mechanization. So when we talk about Education 5.0, we are really talking about being able to educate the mind and educate the hands and educate the whole person to be able to be relevant to the community and to be able to create one's job, so that at the end of the day, you are not waiting for someone to give you a job. But because you have been here, because you have been growing wheat, you have been processing, you are able to go out and do it on your own. That's what Education 5.0 is about. Really, it's about producing someone who is relevant to the country, who is able to produce, who is able to go and hit the ground running.
Your Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, Section 13 of Zimbabwe's Constitution, Subsection 1, which focuses on national development, states that, and I quote, "The state and all institutions and agencies of government at every level must endeavor to facilitate rapid and equitable development, and in particular must take measures to A, promote private initiative and self-reliance, B, foster agriculture, commercial, industrial, technological and scientific development, foster the development of industrial and commercial enterprises in order to empower Zimbabwean citizens." Your Excellency, universities have a responsibility to cause rapid and equitable national development using knowledge and innovation, as enunciated by yourself in Vision 2030. Today, we demonstrate through developments at Marondera University of Agricultural Science and Technology that our institutions of higher learning are the engine of national development. Your Excellency, nyika inokura nokuti tiri kudzidzisani. Your Excellency, our vision of becoming an upper middle income economy by 2030 requires that innovation capabilities be developed. for the attainment of this strategic national intent and to fulfill the requirements of the Constitution. This intent requires that the nation and its people be self-confident and pay attention to our country, to pay attention to our resources, to pay attention to everything. Tikatari samuti kuno tomorrow. In addition, it is important that self-belief, self-adequacy, and self-determination, and having a pioneering spirit among our people is very important. It is all about being a free people. Kuva neurozi husina kumonerwa necolonialism. Kuva neurozi hunoziva kutiswa nani. Kuva neurozi hunoziva kuti hatizvidauti kuti tiri vanhu vakakwana. It is therefore imperative that institutions of higher learning play their part to achieve this vision, providing the required national capabilities. National capabilities can only happen kana takarongeka, takasungika, nyombe dzisina kubhirita. Your Excellency, it is now imperative to think deep, very deep, about the meaning of an economy, about the meaning of economic activity, about the meaning of employment, about the meaning of wealth creation within the context of our realities and the realities of the modern world, which is free from colonial domination. Gone are the days when we used education to prime our graduates to work for others, but not for themselves. Your Excellency, the focus of our education should be on growing skills and knowledge, focusing on number one, growing things, which is agriculture. Number two, kucherazunu, mining things, which is mining. Ta mine, ta growazunu, to gadzirazunu, use these two as raw materials for manufacturing, which is number three. If we cannot grow things, if we cannot mine things, if we cannot manufacture or make or construct things based on the inputs from mining, which is the subsoil economy, and agriculture, which is the soil economy, then there is no economy to talk about. All these economic activities must be underpinned and driven by knowledge. Njere zakapinza, ruziwo wakapinza, ne loyalty to the national cause. This is what we call true education. Your Excellency, turning to true education, we know that true education develops technology and gives industry to a nation. True education eradicates hunger by enabling people to produce food. True education gives people good health. True education connects people. Overall, true education gives the nation dignity. In the Second Republic, Your Excellency, we are guided by the philosophy that a people who know themselves and a people who do not regret about who they are and who can never be stopped by anyone. It is for this reason that we are marching forward to restore the dignity of our people through education. We are of the conviction that education is not a way to escape poverty. Education is a way of fighting poverty, said Julius Kambarage Nyerere. Your Excellency, the higher and tertiary education, innovation in science and technology, national ecosystem that you are constructing is taking us where our ancestors and those who come after us will be proud of. Heritage-based education 5.0 is our method of growing this economy, of growing the spirit of emancipation amongst our people to fight disease, to fight poverty, to fight underdevelopment. The results are there to see today with your opening of the Agro-Innovation Industrial Park. Your Excellency, following your guidance in line with the mantra, leaving no one behind, The Marondera University of Agricultural Science and Technology started an outgrower community scheme, which is 90 hectares and which is used for the people. Muwasi will develop the technology, will support the communities for the development of our country. A university cannot be separated from the communities whose lives it is trying to transform. In other words, Julius Kambarage Nyerere said, if real development is to take place, the people have to be involved. Your Excellency Chancellor, you gave us the confidence that we can build our country stone upon stone. We are developing the capability for a successful rural industrialization program. And we believe that we'll get there.
The Marondera University of Agricultural Sciences and Technology, Agro-Industrial Park, covers approximately 1,020 hectares, with 400 hectares being arable, while 300 hectares already cleared for cropping. The Agro-Industrial Park is one of the beneficiaries of the recently constructed Muchekeranwa Dam. The Agro-Industrial Park is supported by the irrigation facilities that comprises center pivots with a total of capacity to irrigate 260 hectares, tractors, boom sprayers, and planters, among other equipment, with more than 140 hectares under the winter wheat farming and more than 20 hectares under horticulture.
The mandate of the Agro-Industrial Park is to grow crops and the livestock and then value add. We intend to only export out of this farm products that are value added. So we are basically there to grow crops, do value addition, as well as come up with new innovations to better produce crops, vegetables, and animal products. So far, under irrigation, we have got 260 hectares. But of course, the crop we have here is 150 hectares of wheat, but our total capacity irrigated is 260. And then the total, if it's rain fed, is 300 hectares. But we intend to increase that to about 500 hectares.
In a bid to pursue education 5.0, most of the work done at the university is done by the students and lecturers from building to the field.
I'm a student who is a brick and rasim. In the midst of our tertiary education, the Department of Agricultural Construction. Apa currently tiri ku Marondera ndokwatiri kuita ma project e government. Government ya ichatsvage ma workers from ma contracts ayo yakutotora isusu tichiita ma contracts ayo. This program runs for 4 years, and after 4 years I will be able to do any contract on my own. I don't need employment. I can now find my employment on my own.
Ndiri mu apprenticeship fourth year under the Ministry of Higher and Tertiary Education, Science and Technology Development. Tiri kudzidziswa bricklaying, project imwe yatakaita yekuvaka plaque, and tine imwe project zvakare yatiri kuita kudzivara sekuextension kwatiri kusumudza maflats. I encourage others kuti vange vachitiwo zvinhu zvakaita seizvizvi zvekuvaka, nekuti unoona nzvimbo ino inochinja zvinhu zvakawanda mulife mako.
The Regional Registrar, Industrial Training and Trade Testing Department, Harare. And Harare covers Mashonaland East, Mashonaland West, Central, Harare Metropolitan. Within the Ministry of Higher and Tertiary Education, Innovation, Science and Technology Development. Our mandate, among others, includes apprenticeship training, assessment of skills and certification. Where we are right now, because we run an apprenticeship training program in various trades. Currently, I have bricklayers who started as first years. Educational entry is 5 O-levels at C or better. And we train them over the 4 years for the competencies that are required in the particular industry. So instead of using models, the education 5.0, which requires the product to be goods and services, we are now actually taking them into projects. These two apprentices and the others in the background, we pulled them from Zivaraseka, where they are building flats, and they came here. They actually started from reading and interpretation of the plan of this particular plaque, where they had to interpret the plan, do the setting out, trenching, and build this particular item that you are seeing. We also have other trades that we take on apprentices: plumbing, drain laying, motor mechanics, fitting and turning, etc., etc. All in all, we have 180 plus trades where we are training apprentices. And we are saying, after the person has graduated, the person can be self-employed. He can actually do whatever he needs to be. If it's a bricklayer, he can build a house. Plumbers can do the plumbing, drain laying, etc., etc. So all facets, all the competencies they would have acquired before they qualify. And these are people that are going into industry with confidence, because during training they are actually producing the goods that they're supposed to produce during training in that particular trade. So they are exposed to all the skills and competencies. And we have confidence now, any projects within the ministry where their skills are taken, instead of the ministry contracting, we are actually taking apprentices. They are going there, they are doing the work. If you go to the main campus right now, you will also see apprentices who are painting the buildings in preparation for the launch. So these are apprentices in painting and decorating. They are also able to paint all facets using all different types of paints, whether PVA, gloss, enamel, etc., etc. So we are also encouraging those that are sitting and saying, we are not employed, but they've got five O-levels. Let them come to the regional offices. We have five regional offices: Harare, Bulawayo, Gweru, Masingo, and Mtare. Let them come and join apprenticeship training. And we actually assist, instead of you paying fees when you are an apprentice, the ministry, through the fund, the Zimbabwe Manpower Development Fund, will pay for the fees at college, examination fees. And if you are invited to a college which is outside your hometown, the accommodation and meals at the Polytech is actually met by the ministry through the Zimbabwe Manpower Development Fund. And they do get also an allowance, small as it is, during their training. So it's a channel that's open to those that are sitting and saying, we've got the five O-levels, but we have nothing to do.
Despite the fact that works at the Agro-Industrial Park are mainly field-based, environmental issues are taken seriously at this particular institution. Even the administration work is shifted from the office to the field.
I'm an intern at Marondera University in the Academic Registry Department. Our role mainly was to facilitate that the event goes well and everything goes according to the plans of the official launch of the Agro-Industrial Park.
As an environmentalist, I feel that we need to impart our students the knowledge of managing our resources very well, so that in case of disaster disasters and risk, they know how to manage and how to mitigate the effects of disasters. And issues to do with land reclamation, as you know, that we depend on our land. Land is infinite, so if we do not take care of our land, it means that the future generation is going to be affected, as they will not be able to utilize the land.
The Agro-Industrial Park will also be used as a teaching laboratory for students, where they will be exposed to highly mechanized and precision farming, as the institution fosters the use of technology and innovation in all its agricultural activities. Thank you.
advantages of this technology is that you don't need to step on your crops, whereby if you are using a tractor to spray, you find out you lose a lot of tonnage because the tractor is going to destroy certain crops. But because the drone is aerial, it sprays evenly and also at a faster rate as compared to the old ways like using boom sprayers which are being carried by people, and it also provides a uniform application rate to the farmers. When you compare it with the boom sprayers that are being used by people on the banks, you find out a boom sprayer can have the capacity maybe 15 liters or 20 liters, whereby this Agras T30 can use the capacity of 30 liters, which means for every two people, we are using one full tank of a drone. And if you consider the issues of over-application and under-application, this drone will have a uniform spray, because you'll be using a spraying rate. But now when you're using people to spray, it means that there's going to be over-application sometimes and under-application. Then by the end of the day, when it comes to the cost-benefit of pesticide, you may be getting a loss without doing the proper calculations. But with this drone, your calculations are on paper and everything is okay.
The implementation of the Agro-Industrial Park has prompted the enactment of the Muchekeranwa Dam Outgrower Irrigation Scheme. This initiative is said to benefit more than 48 families within the community surrounding the Muchekeranwa Dam, where initially resettled during the construction of the dam.
Vanguva yakakuya hatata ninguva takamirira chinhu ichi kivot saka takapiwa kivot na baba vedu na vamunyangagwa kuti tisenzese tichitora mvura muchekeranwa dam tichidiridza takuita maprofiti tichingochinja kuroteta mbeu dzedu tichibvisa imwe tichiisa imwe tichibvisa imwe tichiisa imwe dinozwa kufara zvikuru nezvatakaitirwa na baba vedu vamunyangagwa.
Zvikuru kwazvo nekuti takanga tichishuwira kwazvo kuti irrigation inge ichizenge ichiitwa takakura tiri pano takakurira pano tichimirira irrigation yazouya nhasi uno after 37 years pakavakwa dhamu saka dhamu iri paravakwa takabviswa tikanogariswa kuma kwaingwa kuri kumafuru tikanzi tiuye kunoku kwatakanga tigere kune land yakurima yakanaka. Ndopa takadzoswa patakati isusu land yedu yose yatakanga tichirima ngatichisiye iri kunoko tiitase tiite land yedu yekuzorima saka isi tiri kunzwa kufara zvikuru kwazvo nemamiriro azvakaita tiri kuzvitambira tingoti hurumende yedu nemaitiro avaitayo dai varamba vachidaro because panapa pane almost 30 hectares dzatorimwa so far dzato ready for irrigation. And my families are going to benefit upon apa. Are going to 48 families. Saka, tukun zwa kufara kwazo. Nima situations ata sangana na u. Nekuti, takanga taka, tisina pe kutangira, demu rakanga raka zara mvura. But mvura yo yanga isina che kushandisko. Tenge taka itarisa, but nasuno, president wakanzu kwa kuchima kwedu pa kwa yapano wachiti furira damu redi. Wakavua tipa equipment. And tine rubatsiro futi watukupiwa neve ipa moasti panapa ndo vari kutibatsira kuti tinge tichiita zvese zvatiri kuita izvi vakabatana nehurumende.
We are working with, of course, besides providing employment, we have started an outgrower irrigation scheme where we help the farmers with technical expertise. We grow, we manage water, we have managed to put a center pivot that is capable, it's towable and is capable of irrigating 90 hectares. So farmers will grow crops, we will do the marketing, and they will enjoy the benefits. So we want our farmers to participate in commercial farming, not to remain, you know, subsistence farmers. At the moment, the total number of enrollment is 392. We don't intend to grow it that much. We will grow maybe to about 1,000, 2,000 and end there, because we want to emphasize ours is an agricultural university. We want to emphasize on hands-on experience and on quality, not on numbers. Of course, future plans, like you have seen now, we have done well in crop production. The next phase is to construct industrial sheds so that we start the process of value addition. And of course, we are building our main campus at Clover Hill Farm, which is 7 kilometers outside Marondera. So there is some activity there where we are already constructing a modern teaching complex and administration block.
We need chairman where my farmers are pan, my rural farmers are pan. Katakalaka dam here. 48 families. I shift to 48 families. Could dam river. So Tawarongera through the Minister of Agriculture, also with the Minister of Science and Technology, University of Marondera University. Tawagadzira panapa first round, pana 90 hectares. Zatapa my families here and they chairman away my farmers actually panapa. Tawa Rimira ne AFC, and they create under the Second Republic. I'm going to go to the next one. Throughout the year, when I go under my crops, program and you put it, but here's what so cap and up and a cap from Mira. You put down poverty. Zimbabwe Zaraka Vakazin, Zagadu, Zakanaka, a Tine program, a fish, worry, and the man come with the Panapataka lunch like a Kana, Gorum, Sakaway investment of Vice Chancellor. What do I do? Zoro could evil say Marondera invest. You are going to breed my fingerlings, a fish, to supply the country, to support us in the room, and to write a revenge. Ava, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? What are you going to do?
There is an old adage which says education is a way to fight poverty. Hence, true education develops technology to avert hunger. The Agro-Industrial Park has on its cards plans to construct produce processing plant in a bid to invest in the value addition process.